My name is James Black. I'm a vascular surgeon here at Johns Hopkins Hospital in Baltimore. I deal with diseases of the arteries and veins outside of the heart. Open repair of abdominal aortic aneurysms is performed usually through two approaches. Sometimes we perform an incision right through the center of the abdomen. That brings us right down to the aneurysm itself, and the aorta is then opened and replaced with a graft. Those grafts we've been placing in patients since the 1950s and are quite durable and will last the patient their entire lifetime. The repair of a thoracic aortic aneurysm using open techniques usually implies that the patient has to lie on the right side, and then the incision comes down between the ribs, and thereafter we flex the chest open and we can get to the thoracic aorta in that location. Similar to the abdominal aortic aneurysm repair, we also replace the aorta in the chest with a Dacron graft, which can last the patient a lifetime with little fear of degeneration down the road. Routine abdominal aortic aneurysm repair, when we do an open traditional surgical procedure, usually requires that the patient comes into the operating room on the day of surgery, and they're in the hospital usually between 5 and 7 days. Usually one or two of those nights includes a stay in the intensive care unit, mostly so we can monitor the patient and make sure that they're coming out of anesthesia safely. And then thereafter, we get them out to the regular hospital floor, start working on moving the diet forward, getting people up and around. And on average, most of our patients with a simple, straightforward abdominal aortic aneurysm repair are going home between 5 and 7 days after the procedure. For a thoracic aortic aneurysm repair, when we do an open repair, the stay is usually longer, mostly because the incision through the chest wall is, by its nature, more painful than that of the abdomen. So we tend to see the patients are in the hospital a little bit longer while we wait to take them off appropriate intravenous medications to help control their pain, move them towards oral pain medications, and then go home. Follow-up after open aortic procedures is dramatically different than that of an endovascular repair. For an endovascular repair, we almost always have to have the patient coming back in the first year, a month after surgery, potentially at 6 months, and then 12 months after the procedure. For an open repair, we generally have the patients come back between 6 and 8 weeks after surgery. At that point, we're mostly beginning to discuss getting back to activity in terms of limiting the weight restrictions that they have upon lifting items, getting back to exercise. We talk about driving. And generally, most of the patients after an open aortic repair are back in the workforce between 2 and 3 months after surgery. Open treatment of aneurysms by its nature is a more risky procedure than that of an endovascular repair. This has been borne out in many studies throughout the last 5 to 10 years. The things we worry about after an open aneurysm repair are mostly related to dysfunction of the kidneys or trouble with the lungs. Of course, people who go into the operation as active smokers are at higher risk for lung problems than those who are not smokers, and unfortunately, smoking is one of the conditions that leads people to have aneurysms. So we have the base problem as the cause of the aneurysm, as well as the cause of most of the postoperative complications. We have an excellent ICU team here, and our nurses are quite strong in terms of managing the pulmonary aspect and the lung aspect of the operation. And luckily, we have had a relatively low rate of pulmonary complications, as well as renal complications or kidney complications after any open repair. The best part about working at Hopkins is working around people who are truly excellent. There is a very high caliber of physicians that we have here at Hopkins. Everybody works as a team. There's no one-upping each other to get ahead. The patient is at the center of the game, and everyone works to get that patient in better shape. I enjoy coming to work because what I do is, by its nature, inherently difficult and somewhat complex, but I like making it look routine. The best reason that patients should consider coming to Hopkins is because we really put the patient at the center of the equation. We know, based upon our own research here at Hopkins, what the best treatments are for a patient and their given medical fitness. There are many physicians here at Hopkins who have expertise in many things. There are many people here who are very good at what they do, and we can really bring it all together to deliver the best outcome for the patient.